Hello, it is. My name is Sonny Victor, and welcome back to Phoenix Wright Tribulations. We're going to cross examine the testimony with the fight with the thief from Look at Me. So, yeah. Wait a minute. It's true. What do you mean by whip before the sight?
Naturally, I can't find no one in there tonight. Look at me, was honey around. It runs forth from the statue of standing by the door to the warehouse.
Sword? You mean the sword that was twisted like a pretty bitch?
Correct. Fortunately for me, the blade was not sharp.
Okay, so he's talking about the shishito. So Tifa is here with the sword. What about yourself with this? You have that much faith in your fighting abilities?
But of course, the college was in second in charge of the boxing club.
I'm sorry if I failed to find it appropriately impressive.
However, my opponent in the right time this time, in the ring this time, was my arch nemesis, Master Mask.
This guy is a real piece of work. Can you tell us a little more about what happened?
My opponent was more powerful than vicious. You might say it was powericious.
Powericious?
I assume that me for distance, but a sudden flash of light blinded me. Then, of course, a checkmate. My opponent had best of me.
What do you do now? Should I ask more about this? What is that, the fighting style?
I'm sorry, but as a trade secret, and I can't say anymore. But I suppose I can tell you, but if you're absolutely must. The main thing is to put your back to the wall, that way no one can get behind you.
That's it? That's the happy fight this time? Well, Mr. Wright must need support. Oh, come here, Portal. We learned how to take a secret technique after all. Yes, indeed. I remember you so innocent if I ever won't take a walk alone at night. Why the heck is he eyeballing, belling me like that? He's screaming out. No, witness. We will go ahead and add a secret information to your official testimony. This is at me. Your testimony is going to be like a horse of cards. House of cards.
My friend, this is Mr. Lawyer. Sir Lawyer, it is really a pleasure to cross swords with you. And now, once again, you have thrown down the gauntlet at my iron feet.
I believe this is what you said yesterday.
No, the coward was the one who was running through somewhere besides the door. And my arch nemesis struck me on the head from behind with the course of item hair.
From behind, huh? But yes, Lord, you testified that he struck you on the forehead. A heart attack you would forget, could forget where you were hit on the head.
It seems as I made another mistake.
That's not the only strange part about your testimony. What do you mean by that? For example, the very fact that you hit the colleague from the police itself is strange. Yeah, that was thinking. That's what I was thinking. It's almost as if you were afraid that we were going to help with security.
Yes, I said myself, I've always been mostly understood or sad.
That's wrong. I still don't know what the voice got with. Got with.
So Air is human to forgive Divine. Humans are machines, they are souls, feelings. They live, they die, they love, they hate. And yes, they even make mistakes.
That rhyme. Hey, hold on, is not the British that?
Really? Really, what is it like that? Always change your riddle down to the end, that's the one of the rules.
This might be just my chance to turn things around.
Mr. Wright, what exactly is that you were asserting?
Very well, Your Honor. The professor says that he's the master mask. The answer is simple. It's not clear to me now. The detective look at me it's at the Trinity is actually master mask.
Oh no, Mr. Wright, what is the meaning of this?
There are too many unnatural parts of Mr. story. He says he was hiding at the crime scenes, which is why no one ever saw him there. And then in his last case, he managed to outperform the technical issue and the entire police force to miraculously retrieve his stolen treasure.
Yeah, that's because I analyzed the crime scene, but I made an extremely elegant deduction. I picked up clues that the police overlooked in order to arrive at a...
Oh, please, the explanation is more simple than that they at me. The truth is that you are in fact the Master Mask.
Mr. Wright, in this photo is clearly shown Mr. Master Mask. The security camera belongs to the Lord Taylor department store. He shouldn't have been able to manipulate it.
He didn't need to manipulate it. He gained access to the warehouse under the pretense of providing... security. It's simply dressed as a thief and stole the urn.
So the ace detective is actually an ace thief! It's just ridiculous!
The master may always prove genius, so ever look at me, the ace detective. You're very clever to come to such a conclusion, I'm impressed, oh lawyer.
What? What is you? You admit it?
Nick, that's what she has! Yeah, she's time to put the last nail in this guy's coffin. Does it at me? What do you ask with the chief's
identity? Why?
God of Plan 102, my personal favorite.
Mr. Gorot! Goro!
The ace detective is actually an ace thief, as well as a selling novel. There's only one problem, it simply isn't true.
But Mr. Goro! Mr. Wright has made some personal points that I...
I still jumped up at the coffee throne. I'll admit my own problem that's over a compelling narrative. Narrative out of a whole class. But it is, in fact, nothing more than a password quilt, Mr. Wright. If this detective is really the thief, then show us the proof that of your claim. But it's better not to be as hot and as perfect as the coffee drip in your face.
Well, Mr. Wright, don't just stand there. The court would like to see this, that this is the proof. You have to, quickly.
Huh? Oh, yes, of course. What's the big rush?
Are you right, Dick?
I've been looking pretty rattled right now. I'd like to finish this right now so I can... But I can really do it.
There's the evidence that Mr. Bruce is at me in Master Fact, Mr. Mask.
proof?
Of course, I got nothing.
Huh, just what I thought. That's a good stuff. A man has to hold his head up high no matter how bad things get, after all.
I see. I thought perhaps you had some evidence to back up your assertion.
This is not good. It had got to stay on the deck.
I mean, if we get around the chest to prove that this guy is the thief.
Don't give up, Dick. Take hard and try again.
It's not good. I'm not ready yet.
But are you going to just give up and let us lose like that?
Oh, yeah, come to your senses, or how you're so lawyer.
I can't think of any counterattack at all.
It seems the cloud of suspicions around the witness are lifted. Mr. Gordon, you have any further objection?
Who are you? That doesn't really matter right now, does it? Mr. Knight, what are you doing here?
Nicky boy, the thing you have been looking for, I think you found it.
You mean the bag?
No, not the bag. Was it in the bag? Well,
the dogs. The second relic! It's the bird!
Oh, you madam! The bird, where did you find it?
You will never believe it. It was in the office of Mr. Fancy Pants Ace Detective. Look at me!
Oh, there's a universe!
Well, how do you expect that, Mr. Acme?
Even you're going to have a hard time wrestling out on this one.
Huh, pathetic.
Mr. Goyle? Oh god. Do you have something you wish to say?
Yes, your honor, it simply reminds me of how quick the times change. In the old days, a man was to be taken to this world. It's really sad.
You still deny that? Mr. Atwood was involved?
Before casting the aspiration of Detective Atwood, consider a young lady here. Her name is Desiree Delight, is that correct?
Yes, what about it?
How charming. The lengths that a woman is willing to go to save her husband is too aspiring.
Why are you so isolating?
As a wife of the criminal, you could not discover the stolen urn anywhere. Including the office of the good detective here. So I found the urn, what does that prove? It certainly doesn't prove where the urn was before you found it.
What? What? Are you spotted here from the office?
Please, madam, this stone is already filled with plain of lies. Anyone could only compound the tragedy we have been witness to.
You're wrong, you would never ever do such a thing.
Mr. Light.
Please, take my. You have to go to help me. The doctor says it to this guy. These people.
The buff is away. I got to prove that the urn was actually in the atmosphere, as you see.
Fingerprints.
I can prove where the urn was by a fingerprint on it.
Fingerprints, eh?
Oh, come on now. No, you're really making me laugh, so loyal fingerprints indeed. May I go on? Good. Now, it will be perfectly understandable if the fingerprints were ruined. After all, it was I who was guarded in the first place. In any case, I was in the habit of wearing clothes, as you can see. So fortunate for my fingerprints were me ever as on anything.
What about it, Mr. Wright? This would just fingerprints were no... In any way.
Nick, what are you going to do now? I could just want to turn back now. Atme must have brought the urn back to the office yesterday, and there, I'm sure someone must have left the fingerprints on it. The first purpose is that the fingerprints of this person should be the old urn.
Me!
So what is all this
fuss about fingerprints anyway.
Miss Atme, do you recall the events of yesterday?
Hey Nick, come on, open it up!
Hey, wait a minute! Why can't you stop on this private property?
Don't be such a funny buddy! Funny daddy, this is an important investigation! Well, what's in there?
Hang on a second. Take it out now. Whatever it is, it feels kinda hard and smooth.
Well, hello there!
It's true that I didn't get a chance to look at your bag at the time. But I didn't touch what was inside.
What? You touched it?
I remember very well. It was smooth and hard.
That was just
Your Honor, I did like the court to examine the fingerprints of the urn. If the fingers are there, then it proves that the urn was detected at his office.
Well, even if your fingerprints are on the urn, it still doesn't prove where they were put, does it?
Of course it does.
What did you say?
Not what I said, it's what that was, I didn't understand the person in charge of the exhibition said.
I promised it was just about glowing. I thought maybe I could make it look more valuable.
Is she policy that machine must have removed any and all fingerprints on it? And the only chance I had to get my fingerprints on it was yesterday, at that Miss Detective Agency.
This blend god of blends 107. I decided it's a little bit too bitter after all.
This bastard's fire! Order, order, I have the defense request! Wraith, take the sword and...
Wait a moment, Your Honor. There's no need for that.
No need, you say?
Precisely. I already know Mr. Wright's fingerprints are on the urn.
What are you saying?
Yes, I finally broke his down. I'm down.
Good luck, everyone. I never defied the rival word of a genie that was forced to create one by myself.
Ew, it was so creepy.
Here I am, the trashy clown.
This guy is starting a fruitcake.
You see, it was me all along. I'm the one and only Master Mask. I hope you all enjoy my little performance.
Well, Mr. Coro, what's Mr. Atme's condition?
He's still in the lobby, laughing insanely on her. I wish he could enjoy the joke as much as he seems to be.
Well, it looks like the matter has been settled. I kept pre-arms close to the persuasive record of a young man, especially with the title of the thief.
Dick, you were great! We're right after all!
Yeah, I guess Mr. Delight really was a thief. The good was it referred to Mr. Delight?
You're wrong, I tell you. I mean, not exactly wrong, so much as right is what I tried to say.
Oh, no, it's not. This can't be happening! No, Ron, why? It was almost finished, and then the thief,
the sneaky, odious thief who's been stealing all the treasures. It's me, I'm him! I'm the one you want! I'm the thief, I have to tell you! So do it! Pronounce me guilty, please! I don't know what the kind of kangaroo court you all think this is, but...
The identity of the thief has already been proven. Please hurry and pass the judgment.
What are you talking about? I want to go first. I'm the thief, I tell you.
Coffee. Oh, that was good.
Mr. Goro, don't you stand there and drink coffee?
Huh. Hey there, Mr. Thief.
Yes, sir.
If you really are a man, then clean up your mess.
I'm afraid I just don't have an idea what you mean.
If you're a bastard mask, then prove it, then that's what it means.
Yes sir, I'll be happy to.
It says, I will be happy to, Nick.
It's kinda cute, he's 100% committed to his fantasy.
Good boy, just remember one thing. A boy only gets one chance in his life to become a man.
I know that! I will fail! I swear!
Okay then talk. We're all listening.
Oh well, let's have a...
Let's have a listen to his confession.
The truth is, I mean, Master Mask all along. I mean, you can prove that they are actually Master Mask, can you? I don't want to have an alibi for that they were stolen after all. I don't want the costume that night to Desley to set it up on the scene of the crime. Look, you can see right there in the photo, that's me. As for the brooch, she snagged it on the door handle and got torn off, that's all. I don't like the direction the door is taking.
But this is how every try goes, at least for me anyway. Every time.
Huh. You're doing great.
Stop it, Mr. Gordon. You're embarrassing me.
Like I said, you're only got one chance to testify, alright? But if you make it through with this fire corner, this with fire course, I will keep my promise too. I will make sure to stay locked up in prison as the one that only true bastard mask.
Thanks so much, Mr. Gordon. I will do my best.
Alright, Mr. Wright, I'm afraid it's time for the cross examination.
Why, Ron?
But you have a escape security card. Or a wallet.
Mr. Wright, this wallet belongs to you, correct?
What happened?
Oh, yes, it is. It lost somewhere. Mr. Wright, where did you find a wallet? You should report to the police right away.
Oh, no, you don't understand. This is an important piece of evidence.
Evidence?
Mr. Wright, when did you first notice that you lost your wallet?
Let's see, I think it was on the night of the crime. But I know it's not hiding, but this here went out for dinner.
This wallet was found at approximately at 1 a.m. at the KB security headquarters.
What? So you're not serious?
Yes, I'm serious. This proved that Mr. Wright was in fact the KB security at night.
No!
So if the defendant was at the KB security at 1 o'clock this morning, the proof that he was that he has a watertight alibi.
No!
Furthermore, considering the distance between the Lord Taylor and KB security, it could have taken 30 minutes to get out of the car. According to error, anyway.
Well, Mr. Ward, you have anything to say? Stop drinking the coffee!
Come on, Mr. Thief. Don't let this guy beat you. Tell me why it's wrong.
You're the one who calls me Thief, Mr. Goro. Alright, I will try. I will do it. I will.
He's really got Mr. Light all worked up.
Yeah, he's like a kid at his first day at school.
Look, it's just ridiculous. Why would I have dropped my wallet in KB security? Someone must have planted it there to make it look like I was there and not in the heist.
Planted there? You're restricted now.
Is there light? You probably dropped your wallet when you took it out to use this, didn't you? The key card on the computer security seal's office.
No!
Huh. Oh, that was pretty good try, Mrs. Wright.
I'm so sorry.
Unfortunately, you overlooked one small thing.
What?
Money, of course. And where would the coffee go? Why would the thief go to KB Security in the middle of the night anyway?
Well, Mr. Wright, it looks like you need some more evidence after all.
Ah, the stupid kid.
No, then let's see your evidence. The evidence that shows why Mr. Wright went to KB Security after night. Because of the blackmail.
Yeah.
Yep.
Is it light? I believe you have seen this before, am I correct?
Oh, that's... What is this? What is it?
A blackmail letter, that's what it looks like from the contents.
Blackmail?
Yes, basically it says bring $50,000.
That certainly sounds like a blackmail, right?
At the time of the theft, Mr. Light was dealing with the blackmailer himself. It came in security to see himself in a full half an hour away from the serious crime.
No!
Why take your coffee?
I can't believe he doesn't go to the toilet after drinking so much coffee. Order! So when the theft of the urn occurred, the defendant was at the gaming security. He looks like the perfect case for a defense.
You may see it as a perfect case, Judge, but to me... Well, you say that this would go to bed 107 pressing me a lot more.
But what are you trying to say?
You say that the thief was being blackmailed by the CEO of the security company. But did you actually investigate the CEO at all?
No, I guess. I guess not.
Accusing a man of blackmail with no proof, I'm not sure what I think of that.
Not sure what I think of that? At least I know what I think of you.
Point. I'm not sure what to think of it myself. I claim that the defendant entered the CEO's office. But you would need at least one witness to corroborate your claim, Mr. Wright.
Nick, I think we're going to have to track down the CEO guy.
No, we don't have the track down the CEO at all.
What do you mean by that, Mr. Wright?
There's someone else who can testify.
This is the person who can testify to the key. It's Larry. But... Who is this useless looking young man? I don't remember him.
You don't remember, Your Honor?
Not exactly. Where have I seen this guy before? No, I don't remember. But just like this picture makes the bile start to race in my throat.
It looks like he doesn't remember the case from 2 years ago.
He probably blocked out that memory on purpose. Anyway, this man was working as a guard at the keeping security at night.
Oh?
The question at the hand is his key card.
Yep, but that's the key card that he used in the building I'm working. According to the serial number, there was this one is for the sales office. You need to get into the room every time you use the guard that leaves the record. Yeah, it is. Just use exactly where the room when I went.
As you can see, there's no need for investigating the CEO of KB Security. We should be able to discover the truth simply by analyzing this key card's data. He only got this coffee by doing that. For us to do that.
Well, Mr. Goro.
The name of the CEO of the KB Security is Kane Bullard. I was unable to contact him directly, but I got the key card data here.
So what is you?
Each key card has their own serial number and delivered details records of their use. According to this data, this card was used at the 1 AM on the morning of the crime.
But that means... It can't be missing. Delight, Tristan's best ambassador for all.
Huh. It looks like you were right. 2 minutes is leaving enough time to be a good cup of joe.
So then... coffee.
Rod Delight was clearly in the office of the KB Securities. See you at the time of crime. The prosecutor's office is ready to admit the fact. Therefore, is it possible for the defendant to be Master Mask?
Good job, you did it!
That's enough! I came previously to close with Miss Stream with the record of an innocent young man, Miss Mishing him with the title of thief. What's wrong, Your Honor? I already passed judgment, but before I do that, do you have any further objections? Please don't object more in way, please.
No, Your Honor.
Very well. The court finds the defendant, Mr. Rodney Knight. Not guilty! Yay, confetti, yay! Court is adjourned. Oh, finally!
Nick, you did it! You were right after all! Actually, I'm a little bit ashamed of myself. Nicky boy!
Oh, Mr. Light!
I knew I could do it. I believe you went all wrong with Nicky boy. I don't know how I can ever repay you.
Oh, thanks, Mr. Light. I just know I'm blushing.
Congratulations, Mr. Nick!
Oh, pearls! I got a bad feeling about it.
Who is this woman?
Oh, she's nobody. Yes, she has.
You're blushing! How dare you do this in front of Mr. Fire? You should be ashamed of yourself!
Ouch! She slapped me!
Pearly? This woman is Mr. Stream Delight. She's our client's wife. Mr. Nick!
Yes?
You're worse than I thought! Going behind the back of our client!
No, you got it wrong!
I will never forgive you!
Oh! A double slap!
But anyway, all's well that ends well, right? We got a second round back and the thief has been caught.
Yes, alright. It's all thanks to Nicky Boy here.
But actually, it was me, Mr. Light.
The brothers are burned back.
Thank you for the bottom of the heart.
Oh, please. You're embarrassing me. If it was the case, then why does this guy look so glum?
But I'm thief, actually. What's the point in?
What is it, honey? I did my best for you, Ronnie.
I know that and I appreciate it, Jesse. But the thing is...
Come now, give the kid some time. He is the...
Oh god, why are you tired?
He's just got a little touch of the blues. You know about feeling blue, right, amigo?
Mr. Goro, what are you doing here?
Oh, come on. I just came here to say thanks to my newest buddy. You, Mr. Trite.
He's drinking much coffee, but his teeth is so white. Maybe you should learn my name before you call me buddy.
Well, playtime is over. Huh? Early this morning, the body of Cato Bullard was discovered.
Cato Bullard? I didn't hear that name before.
Goro said it just before the trial ended.
Isn't that the name of the CEO of the Cape Security? Body?
The estimated time of death was 1 a.m. on October 12th.
1 a.m. on October 12th? You don't mean...
That's right, amigo.
That's right.
Oh boy!
At the same time that the ship to learn was being stolen, the CEO of KB Security was being murdered.
So then, what are you doing here?
Oh come on, you figured out already how you amigo, or have you already forgotten about the piece of info I helped you out with today?
Help me out? What?
On October 12th at 1 a.m. 1 o'clock in the morning.
Rod Delight was in the CEO's office.
The scene of the murder. After getting that blackmail letter, he must have been imbued with utter rage.
What are you saying? Imbued rage?
Come on, don't tell me you didn't know it. Rod the Lightfull was an employee of KP Security. He was a professional security guard.
An employee of KP Security?
It looks like the Albert that saved him from being convicted as a thief is going to be the noose that gets him hanged, kind of an anti-alibi.
No way!
He can't be the thief because he was the murder scene of when the murder occurred.
No, that's a lie! It can't be!
I'm a thief, I tell you!
Roll the light, you're going back to the prison again. This time the charge is much serious. This time you will be tried for murder.
What?
This is impossible!
Looking forward to another exciting showdown, Mr. Wright. You and I aren't through with each other yet. Surely you won't be back down from a shelter you will never be uncovered.
Mr. Nick, is this of a personal between you two?
I return from the depths of hell to bark with you. At least let me have some fun while I'm here.
This guy, who the heck is he? He may be quiet, but he's the most dangerous enemy I ever faced.
Well then, time to say goodbye to Mr. Delight. And excuse me, I have to go to the toilet too. I hold it in there so much longer. For so long.
Nick, how could this happen? Right in front of our eyes, our client has been arrested for murder. And the one who established his presidency was me. Yeah, Robbie!
Arrested for murder on the very same day he is declared innocent of legacy.
What the heck is going to happen next?
That's a mystery.
Okay guys, that's it for this episode.
So we got Ron declared not guilty, and then he was innocent charged for murder.
Yeah, so we're going to investigate or talk to him next. So yeah,
thank you for watching. Leave a like, comment, subscribe if you liked it. Thank you for support, and hope to see you in the next episode. Bye bye.